In this video, I will upgrade the DL24 load from 180 watt to 360 watt. In order to increase the power, we will change the heatsink into this one, the MOSFET into a bigger one, and finally the software, because we need to cheat and make the voltage reading to be half than what it seems. I made a MOSFET selection table showing which part number is the most effective depending on the power level. Note that the real max power is much less than declared. For instance, 1600 watt can be just 350 watt if the heatsink is 90 degrees. Let's disassemble the load now. Pull apart the heatsink. Remove the old MOSFET. Please note that the thermal pad is on the upper side and the plastic on the bottom. Let's remove the two small connectors, because we will solder some wires, and then let's try to populate the new MOSFET. We have also to bend the leads in order to touch properly, and the MOSFET has to stay completely flat on the surface of the PCB. Let's put some thermal grease in order to have even a better contact and dissipate also on the front of the MOSFET. Press the MOSFET down while you are soldering the leads, so it will stay completely flat on the surface. Let's mount on the bottom a piece of aluminum to reinforce the PCB. I will place also a thermal pad so it is electrically insulated. Use the Noctua heatsink holder instead of the original one, which is made by plastic and is not strong. I used the four black spacers in the Noctua fan, and all the hardware mounted is taken from the box from Noctua. I used the thermal paste that came with the fan. Probably this is not the right amount of paste and not even the right method. Let's see what is the result. I used an XT60 connector because it gives more space and it is much stronger with the current. And let's place the heatsink on the top now. Check if the MOSFET is flat and the spring are a little compressed on the screw. Let's install the second fan. If you use the Y connector present on the Noctua fan, you can attach it directly on the connector of the load. You just have to align it on the right. And we are finally done. Now let's calibrate it. Let's set the input at 60 volt. 60 volt at the input, and in fact it's reading 60 volt. Let's go to the calibration menu. The reference expected is 30 volt, I press yes. And now, at 60 volt, is reading 30 volt. And now, let's test it. I place a thermocouple directly at the heatsink, in the hole we made before. This is passing through the hole of the transistor and touching directly the cold plate. I attach a 24 volt battery and I check that the reading on the load is half of the expected. Then I go for constant power and I will increase the power up to 180 watt slowly. So the real maximum power synced will be 360 watts. After 15 minutes I got approximately 62 degrees between the MOSFET and the heatsink, and 50 degrees directly at the heatsink at the side of the MOSFET. This is sufficiently low to allow us to dissipate 360 watts. In summary, the load is now able to sync 360 watts. You can easily go back to the correct voltage reading by recalibrating it. All the hardware and plugs came from the Noctua box directly. The D15 is the best air cooler in the market, and the intention is to reach the 720 watts in the next videos.